Hey guys, welcome back to Better Biomed. Well, today's one of those days where I wasn't expecting on being back to work, but here I am. This kind of stuff happens because yesterday I dropped a cable down a hole, and there shouldn't have been a reason that this cable could fall down the hole. It should have been secured properly. But as soon as I lifted the cover up off this floor plate, the cable just went down 8 to 10 feet down a hole. So anyway, this is one of those days and one of those situations where I'm thankful that I have the correct stuff to do what I need to do. I have been ridiculed and I have been criticized online for having all these crazy tools, some of them very one-off tools that people say I'll never ever use. Well, guess what, guys? Sometimes I do. And when you do, you really do. How else are you gonna get a cable out a 10-foot drop? So I go home and I pick up one of my special tools that normally would be here at work, except I migrated most of my tooling at home. And I brought it back to work here on Saturday, and we're here to fish this cable out. And guess what? After a little bit of time getting used to whatever's down in the hole, kind of mapping out everything, making sure I'm not pulling on the wrong cable, I finally connected with the correct cable and I pulled them back up. I'll tell you what, let's take a look right now and I'll show you what I'm talking about. All right, guys, this is the mysterious hole, and it goes way down there, guys, way down there. And this is the broken cable that fell down the hole. As soon as I pried up the glue, they actually glued this floor plate to the ground instead of fasteners. So they glued it to the floor, and as soon as I pried it up, this cable here slipped out of that little hole, went down, way down there, and I knew I was gonna have to find a video scope. See this guy right here? I don't even remember what I paid for it. It was probably like $60, $70, something like that, maybe $30, $40 on Amazon. But it comes with these little hooks, and you can see I added a paper clip so that I could, as soon as I jam it over the correct cable, like so, it was gonna be captured in one or the other of these hooks. So, that's what I did, and I got the cable out, and you can see how difficult the cable is to get out of that little trap once it's in there, which is the whole purpose. I mean, because you don't want to let it go once you got it. So here it is. I got it back up out of the ground. Here is my video scope that somebody wrote and said I'll probably never ever need that as a biomed. Here it is. There's this carrying case. Cool thing about it is I can just leave it charged sitting in the case for the day that I do need it. And just, I'll tell you 100%. Whatever I paid for this, it just paid for itself. I'm in a very special OR room, and this room here generates tens of thousands of dollars every single day. And to not have this GE patient monitor cord, it kind of shuts down this room. If I would have paid somebody to come and fish that out, it probably would have been well over $1,000 to fish that out and run a new cable, this one here. So that's the other thing I'm gonna show you guys, is we are going to run a new cable in the stead of that one, because that one's broke. So that was the point of this whole project, and I'm gonna show you right now. The first rule of running the cable is, if you're not working off a spool, to spread out your cable. You can see, whoop, I got it all spread out, wrapped up here, and I'm ready to tape it, because we're gonna use the old cable as a pull to pull the new cable in reverse down through the hole into the control room. So don't cut your cables ever, ever, ever. Always use them as a reverse pull to go down through. And you can tell that this looks like a 4-inch conduit. So I'm gonna have plenty of space. There are some obstructions and stuff down there, and I'll have to fish it around a little bit. But nonetheless, I'm expecting that. So the one thing that I can prevent is binding of the cable and make sure that the cable doesn't drag anything else down the hole. So I'm going to clean up this stuff here, get it out of the way, clean everything around this hole, and we are gonna tape that cable to this one. So let's do it right now. One of the first things I should show you guys is that when you need to look down a hole like that, do not look down the hole with your regular flashlight, okay? Because if you do, you're probably going to drop it down the hole. Look at how deep this is. That flashlight goes down that hole, you ain't never gonna get it back. So you can see what I did. I took a power cord, I cut the end because it was a bad power cord anyway. I taped my flashlight to the cord and I tied the cord off to something. I probably could have tied it to there or whatever so that the whole cord doesn't go down the hole. See? So now I got a flashlight. If I need to look down the hole, I can look, no problem. My flashlight's tied to something and I can drop it. And furthermore, I can put it down the hole when I really need to see what's down there. You can see it is way, way down there. So that's a quick tip, guys. Don't drop your flashlight. Tie it to something whenever you're looking down into a cavity. All right, I'm going to clean the area. Make sure that nothing is going to bind. Because I want this pole to be as flawless as possible. All right, here we go. So, one of the first things that you need to do is you need to take the cable, the old cable, and the end of the new one, and you are gonna try to match them up as best as possible so it's as small of a footprint as possible. If I were to bind these like that, that is a very fat area. That is not a good idea. So what I'm gonna do, you can see that it's kind of bent like that. I am going to wrap this whole guy in a cone. So you want it to be slender at one side and slender at the other side and maybe a little fat in the middle. And the reason that you want it to be conical like that is because that way there you can pull it in both directions. Because if you reach a stop point, you have to backfeed the new cable all the way back out. So guys, this is where we start taping. I generally like to use the silk tape. The silk tape works really well. It's extremely strong. So like I said, we're going to match the two cables up. You can see how I'm gonna do it. My first wrap is going to be right around the middle to hold both cables exactly where I need them. And now I'm going to wrap forward to make the cone, okay? So I'm going to do another wrap to secure the cable. This is going to be an extremely strong bond. If you're pulling network cables and stuff, there's lots of ways of, like, you put the cable like this and you wrap it and you wrap it forward. But because this is a pre-terminated cable, and we don't want to bend it very much because obviously it's extremely expensive and I don't want to break it because then I would be doing this all over again. So you can see what I'm going to do. I'm going to wrap it really, really tight. And then what you want to do is give it a pull. Okay? And give it a hefty pull because that's what you're going to be doing if it gets bound up. Okay? So on this DB9 connector, there's gonna be little pegs back here. You see them right here and right here? That's your screw downs. If you have screw downs, make sure you wrap extra around there because that is a point where it's gonna bind when you try and shimmy it to pull it back out, if you need to pull it back out. So I'm gonna put another extra wrap right here, right around those ears, those screw downs. Do it really well, just like that. So we have a taper here, we have a taper here, and there's a wee bit of taut fabric right here near those screw downs. So I can probably shimmy it and pull it all the way back. So I'm gonna do one more wrap going forward. Okay, so I'm gonna start here at the cables. We are gonna wrap around. Going forward, okay? So, there we go. There's the hole. I'm gonna drop my cable down in it, just like so. And now I gotta go to the control room and pull it through from that side. Well guys, after about a half hour worth of shimmying and slight pulling and making sure I'm not pulling any cables, you can see my cable made it all the way through. I've got quite a bit here in the room and enough to run all the way up to the GE monitor. Let's take a look and see what I was dealing with. So this is it. The GE monitor is right up there. This is where my cable is. And you can see what I'm working with. There's some fire stop going to the conduit. I had to peel and pry that back, you know, to get the cable out. But the trick to shimmying cables, you don't just straight up yank. You want to give it some tugs to get the cable vibrating, and then give it a slight pull, and then reset. Give it some tugs, you know, some short pop, pop, pops. That gives the cable vibrating down in the conduit, and then you pull it up a little bit, and then do it again and again. And you're inspecting the cable as it's pulling through, and you got to be very careful. So when you feel it binding, you can see that this guy had some rubs, but it came through completely intact. I was extremely happy about that. So all I gotta do is run the cable up above the desk, back to the GE monitor, and this job is done. So guys, running cable is something that we biomeds do. Just be sure to take your time and make sure you're not damaging your cables, because in other words, why even run the cable if you're gonna damage it, all right? This time I didn't use cable lube. Sometimes you need to. I figured the conduit was gonna be large enough diameter, I wasn't gonna need it. It is kind of a, it's that silicone type of sticky type of cable though. And that could have been a pain in the butt. It would have been easier if I would have used some cable lube or some rubbing alcohol. I've used rubbing alcohol before too, and that will naturally evaporate. Leaves, you know, if you're doing a short run, rubbing alcohol works really well. Maybe some hand sanitizer, because it stays liquid for a little bit longer than regular rubbing alcohol. But guys, what a little bit of a job. And I'm so glad that's done. But sometimes, guys, we biomeds, we have to run cable. So be sure you have the right parts, make sure you take your time, and make sure you have the right tools, man. That video scope saved this job, completely saved the job. It was 30, 40, 50, 60. I don't even know how much money it was. It wasn't very expensive and I got it off Amazon, but I'll tell you what, I'm glad I had it, because you never know. Let's say you lose something above ceiling on the drop ceiling, you got a leak or something. You gotta run a cable. You wanna check it out before you run the cable through the conduit, just to be sure that there's enough real estate in the conduit to handle another cable. You never know. But having a video scope can be a game changer, all right? So that's all I got, guys. I hope you enjoy this. I'm tired, I'm going home, and I'm gonna drink some rum, because this was a little bit of a stressful job. And it took this OR down. This is a hybrid OR room, and without patient monitoring, the room is technically down. So I'm glad that this one's all tidied up and we're good to go. Thanks for watching, guys.